Hi everyone. Today I thought I would talk about bucket drumming a little bit. And bucket drumming can be really fun. And first thing you need is a bucket. And if you don't have a bucket, you can use a storage container. This is one of my old ones. And if you don't have drumsticks, I happen to have drumsticks. I'm a music teacher, so I have everything right. But if you don't have drumsticks, if you have spatulas at home, if mom or dad has, or Grammy or whoever has spatulas that they use to cook with, if you want, they are perfect drumsticks because they're not too loud if you play them this way. And they bounce really well. And if you like to be a little louder, you like to make a little noise like I do, you can use the stick part. But to be honest, the best sound, oh, I just dropped one. The best sound is going to be right with the rubber ends there. So you may use that, and you can use your container to play. I'll put it on top by, and you can use that either way. So we're going to play a song today, and we're going to use some different rhythms. Now, if you have drumsticks, if you have a brother or sister, or by chance you have a pair laying around the house, the correct way to hold them is you take your pointer finger and your thumb and you hold it between those two fingers, and then the rest of your fingers curl gently around. That's it. That's how you hold them. You don't point your fingers on them. That way it doesn't kick back and hurt your finger. You just curl your fingers. This gives you control. When you hit your drum, you have to make sure that your stick rebounds right back up. So it almost bounces right back up. If you play like this, it doesn't give you the bounce and the sound isn't as good. So we're going to play on two different areas of our drum today. We're going to play on the drum head, and we're also going to play on the rim, so it gives us a different sound. So you've got those two different sounds, which is fun. If you use your container, you use the center. I actually like that. That's a better bass drum sound than my bucket. So if you use that, this actually sounds more like a drum set than the bucket. So you could use the center of that and the side of that as your rim. I actually might continue on with this drum because it does sound better, but maybe you can see the green one better, so I'll leave that one. So we're gonna play some rhythms. And on the side of the screen, I'm going to put the music up. And you're going to see the quarter notes and eighth notes. And since I'm not right there to point out the beats and things, I'm going to show you the patterns that we're going to play. And they're fairly simple. And where the song we're going to do is Shake It Off. And at the beginning, we're just going to keep the beat. So we're going to count. The beat is in four, so it goes 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. On beats 2 and beat 4, we're going to play our sticks together. So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's our first beat pattern. The first rhythm pattern we're going to play after we do the stick clicks goes like this for the chorus. This is where we're going to play it. It sounds like this. It goes 1, 2, and 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. That rhythm pattern is only 2 measures long, but we repeat it quite a lot. During the chorus, we repeat this beat pattern. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 1, 2, and 3, 4. We repeat that 2 measure pattern 16 times. So you'll get really good at it by the end of the song. That's for the chorus. Then when the verse begins again, we play just the stick clicks. So we play 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the most important part is that you're playing with the beat. Yeah. Then after the chorus, there's a part that's the breakdown where Taylor Swift raps a little bit. She goes, my X-Man, but in this version, we don't have any vocals. It's just strictly instrumental. So we're going to keep the beat right on the drum head. And the beat goes like this. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, and 3, 4, and 1, 2. rest, rest. One, two, and three, four, and rest. And you can use two hands if you want, because that's good to alternate hands, which is what I'm looking for. One, two, and three, four, and one, two, rest, rest. One, two, and three, four, and one, two, rest, rest. One, two, and three, four, and one, two, rest, rest. And that's for the whole breakdown section. The song ends with the chorus, and the chorus is repeated three times. So let's try it with the music. All right, so this is a little bit of a balancing act for me to be able to press play and then be able to play. So I'll jump in where we can. But the intro starts with our stick clicks. All right, let's try it here. Shake It Off. Truly listen to a song, you'll find out that the drummer plays the same beat the whole song. Sometimes he'll play something called a fill, and he'll play it on his toms, and it'll sound a little bit different, but the beat is the same. The beat never changes. So you can do bucket drumming with any song you like. If you like to play Sweet Home Alabama, if you like to play Try Everything, whatever song that you like, you can play a drum beat to. And it might be something you can experiment. And you don't have to have fancy drum sets or the fancy drumsticks, although they do work a little bit better, but these sound really good. But just have fun keeping the beat, playing music. I do like playing drums because sometimes if I'm having a bad day, and this might drive your parents nuts, but it's kind of fun to get your frustrations out. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this lesson, and take care.